Hello, hello everyone, welcome back. And today I wanted to take care of a little annoying thing with my compression system that we set up a few episodes back. I don't know if you notice when I'm crafting, but every once in a while I'll run out of iron or tin or something and I'll have to request another stack of it just to get my recipe complete. So today I wanted to work on creating a buffer system, like actually storing a buffer of this amount of items, and that's going to be working with craftables too. So I'll store X amount of glass, X amount of iron ingots, gold, etc. We'll do the same thing with hardened glass, all sorts of stuff that we're using a lot of. Maybe I'll even create a buffer for item ducts and stuff like that too. Don't know. We'll figure that out. But that's the plan for today, and how I'm going to handle that is with Applied Energistics subnetwork. You don't have to use a subnetwork, but I thought it would be kind of a fun way to do it. Fun way to go about it is make a subnetwork. Oh, and by the way, I still have to move these crucibles. We'll take care of this soon. These crucibles are really causing some frame lag. It's getting annoying. It's getting kind of annoying being around these crucibles and getting the frame lag. Alright, so like I said, we're going to be creating a subnetwork, so I could use ME chests just because each chest would have a 1K in it, or I could use a drive. Do I care enough to use a drive? Or should I just use ME chests in one case? ME chests would be kind of neat. I think they would be. I don't ever use ME chests, so this could be a chance to use it. By the way, this new smeltery, it's running really good. I haven't left the server running full time yet, but so far it's looking good. It's not really keeping up with the liquids. What I might do is create another set of basins. Just have another set of 9 basins. Yeah, because you can see we do have a fair amount of overflow. It's not the end of the world to have overflow. I don't know. We'll let it run and we'll see how it goes. Because like I said, it's only been running since you've seen it and since I've seen it. The server hasn't been online since the last time we've seen this thing run. Well, what happened there? That's interesting. Give it a little block update. Are we good now? Weird. Our lines broke. That's really strange. I don't think I've seen that happen before. Let's see if any others are broken. They look okay. That was strange. I've never seen that happen before. Okay, back on the project. Let's get that subnetwork up and running. Whoops. What's my fly key again? I don't remember. Let's get that subnetwork up and running. So I'm going to need another... do I know how to make a crafting terminal? No, let's teach it how to make a crafting terminal. Do I need a crafting terminal? No, I don't. Let's teach it how to make a terminal, though. So let's get a terminal. One view. What else should we teach it? ME controller. Controller as well. One of you, you should be crafting up both. Perfect. ME controller. ME terminal, that's all I'll need there. I think I'll go with chests. Yeah, let's go with ME chests, just because it sounds like fun. ME chest. I know I'm gonna need 9 for my craft. Let's go with like 20 to begin with. So let's go with, yeah, 20. Because that'll give us room to expand. Maybe I'll want 10 more. Let's go with 30. Maybe I should just go with a drive. Oh dear. Oh, I kind of like chess. Chest will be cool. But a drive would be much more compact. Yeah, let's go with a drive. Let's cancel that job. Chest would be cool, but I have so much stuff I kind of want to have in a stockpile that I should probably just go with a drive. But would that work, though? Would that work? Let's just do a demo with the chest, and then we can see if it'll work. Let's go with ME chest to begin with. Let's get 10. 10 chests. Storage, you know how to make one case? No, we don't want 64 case, we just want some one case. One case storage, code. It's crafting me up some chests. I'm gonna need an interface for the subnetwork. I already have one. Good interface. We're gonna need a lot of ME cables. You should probably just let me grab all this and I'll be back. That'd be the smarter thing to do. By the way, remember to keep charging your force armor if you made a set with me, because we ran out of force and it's almost dead. Just gonna quickly expand this area down here too, because I think this is where I'd want to put the subnetwork, pretty close to my compressors. It just makes sense to have it here. And I'm still crafting up some stuff as well. Just thought I'd update you. So I think I got just about everything I need to set up the subnet. I got my emitters, cables, precision exports, ME interface, access terminal, controller, my chest, and a drive, and a storage bus. I think this is about everything I need. Oh, I'm also going to need conduits, because this stuff does need power. Make me some hardened. Should be a good enough start. I got a lot of stuff auto-crafting right now. I have a feeling I'm going to need more power over here too, so it might be time to upgrade this line. We'll see. We'll see. Okay, to set up this subnetwork, I think I'd want it in this corner here. We'll put the subnet right here. I could even put it right beside this one. Okay, let's think about this before I go crazy here. If I run a cable off from here, this will access my subnet. Oops, three. This will access my subnet, which will be connected to an interface. It has to be connected to an interface to recognize it as a subnet, by the way. I want it to be extract only. That's a pretty important setting. I don't want it to be putting stuff into this chest from here. I want to do that from another side. And if I set up my subnet here, basically controller, access terminal, which is unnecessary, but it's kind of nice to see what's in here. That should be the basic of the subnet. We're going to need to run power here. Which we can do so through here. I'm gonna switch these two around. Whoops, broke a block somehow. The controller on the top so it gets power, and we'll put the access terminal on the bottom. Everything should be happy there. So I think I'd want my row of chests, say, here. These are ME chests. You need to put in a storage cell in them, and now they'll be ready to go. They also need power. So I think I'd run power underneath. And I want my emitters to emit from the subnet, because these are like, these are the emitters that I'll grab, so you can consider these like requesters. These are like requesting emitters, and these will be like supplying emitters. You could think of it that way. Because I'd want this network to tell Yeah, this network will be exporting into the chests, and this network will be emitting when to do it. So if I place that there, I face the emitter upwards, and the emitter's connected to the subnet. That should be fine. And the subnet will connect right to there. I'll just fly underneath. Really quick, like. That should take care of the connection there. I also need to run power to it. We'll power the chest from the top. We'll just put another line of conduits this way. Something like that it'll look like. Alright, so this chest is now only connected to this subnet, and the subnet is only allowed to extract to the main network. So that should do the trick there. This chest is now powered. It has a precision export from the main network. So I think we're good on this. Let's get some stuff set up. I need some iron. Iron will be our demo for this. So the goal of this whole setup is to have certain things I want, like I said before, in a stockpile. So I want some iron. I'm sick of having to request items for a crafting recipe. I want it to have that ready to go for me. So, where's my iron assembler? This one's my iron assembler. So first thing I'm going to do is change this to emit a redstone signal when we have 64 ingots. So this will now only emit when we have 64 or more ingots. And this will have set to emit when we have 63 ingots. Emit when levels are equal to above. Yeah, this should be good, because this will emit a signal when we have 63 ingots and tell it to stop pulling into this chest. And this will tell it if you have 64 or more from our magic crops farm that's auto-processing our our ores, our essence ores. So that should be good there. The iron should be set up now. I could tell this to precision export without signal, because I want this opposite of the other one. And we're going to set this to always craft items, because that's what it's going to do. It's going to craft the items from our multi-block. It's going to say, okay, now I need some ingots. I need to craft the ingots until I have 63 of them and then stop. That's the plan anyways. This drive, we could set it up. I don't think there's any point to having this partitioned, but we could for the sake of it. Let me think about this. Is there any point of having this partitioned? Because I'm not going to be ever throwing anything into this network but what I want. I think I should have it partitioned just in case anything goes wrong. But what could possibly go wrong? I don't think anything could go wrong with this, because nothing should be allowed to enter this network. This is set to extract only, and this is on a precision export. It should be good. Let's see. Precision export, iron and guts. It should stock at 63, emit a signal, we're done. And this should not be pulling into the assemblers until we have 64. I think we're good. And this precision, or the storage bus, is telling it that it can only extract from this subnet. You need the interface there or it won't interact. If I took away this interface, it would just shut down both controllers, because you're only allowed one controller on a network. If you didn't have the interface here and you just connected a line or a storage bus or whatever, it would shut down both controllers and your network would just stop. So I think this is perfect. Now let's go check our interface upstairs, and we should have 63 iron available. Oops. Iron. 63. It's kind of fluctuating a bit, but that's okay. It's only keeping 63 in that basement. Now when I pull this out, it should auto-craft more. Perfect. That's what I want to see. That's what I want to see. Yeah, you're at 63. If I pull it out with my wireless interface, we should see this fill up immediately. Nice. That's perfect. And let's say if I put more than 63, it shouldn't be able to pull because I have this set. Oh, it should be able to pull. So if I put this much, it should see that and start pulling it, right? No. But if I put the extra, if I put the extra into this network, it should start pulling it into my assembler. Yes, it is. Good. This network, like I said, I should never access this network. It should be automatically done. And now my assembler should be turning that excess iron back into blocks, and it'll stop when it hits the marker. Good. Good. So yeah, I'll go over the setup one more time. Storage bus set to extract only into an interface, set up with a controller. The terminal's not necessary. And this is a subnetwork that the network doesn't see, except for just knowing that there's items there that it could pull. The subnetwork's hooked up to the chest. The chest has a simple 1K. It's storing now 63. And the export bus is coming from the main network, which is set to emit without a signal, because this is a reversed emitter. This is like a supplying emitter. So it's telling it when you have 63 ingots, stop the precision export. That's great. And I did have to change this emitter to be 64, so when you have 64 or more, then the assembler will run. That's the whole setup. I'm going to replicate this a few times and get some more goodies set up in a stockpile. Alright, I just moved stuff around a bit too to make it easier for further expansion. So this is going to look how look like our lines when we're done. Oh, this is upside down. This is going to look like our lines when we're done. Why aren't you connected? There we go. Emitters coming out of the subnetwork, extractors coming out of the main network, and that should take care of that. And I have this line kind of separated, so they'll never touch. If these touch, things are going to bungle up. So these can never touch. These two networks never, ever, ever touch. And this is how it's going to look. I just, like I said, I just moved it around so I can expand in the future as many times as I want to have craftable items. That's it. Just switched up the layout. Everything else is the same. By the way, I don't think you need power to these chests, because it looks like it's working just fine. I think the ME line is powering the chests. Yes, it's definitely powering the chests. Power to the chest, not necessary, when you have a controller. If I didn't have the controller, I'd probably need to power the chest. Back to setting this up. So I'm starting to set up the quartz, and I think I'm going to go with the same way, because this is 64 and it takes 4 quarts to compress. I'm going to set it to an uneven number on the requester. And the supplier, we're going to set to 64. And I think that'll be the same method as my ingots, which is doing a great job, by the way. They're all holding nice and steady. It stabilized the system. It's no longer doing anything wonky. It's great. It's working really great. So let's try this out. Let's see. I'm going to have this set to 65 quarts. This is set to request or supply 64 quarts. And we're going to put our export in. Do I have an export? Oh no. I'm out of exports. I got a couple made. I'm making some more. It's just taking a while. So export. We're going to set you to active without signal. Always craft. Quartz. So now we should supply 64 quarts. On the dot. Any excess will get pulled into the assembler. Nice. That's working. Okay, just thought I'd update you on how I'm going to do even numbers. I'm just going to uneven the requester emitter. I hope you get what I'm saying, how these are emitters that are supplying a request signal, and these are emitters that are supplying a supply signal. Back to setting it up. Back for another short minute just to show you the hang-up we're having with the furnaces. I have two recipes trying to use this one furnace, and it's really hanging up my crafting. This is something else we're going to solve today. So I did set up this one to hold 256 glass. So it's really hanging up my crafting. We're going to devise another system to have all of our AE stuff, all of our AE recipes on its own separate network of furnaces too. That'll come up next. Actually, instead of waiting for stuff to craft, I think I'm going to do this now. I'm going to set up another network. Not another subnetwork, but I'm going to set up another system to manage what we want. So Let's see, do I have redstone furnaces encoded? Don't think so. Let's teach us how to make redstone furnaces. Redstone furnace encode. I don't know if it knows how to make a brick or if it knows how to make clay bricks. We'll take care of that. Redstone furnace. Let me get stuff together. Okay, so I think I got pretty much everything I need to accomplish the setup I want. Let's sleep through the night really quick so we can see what we're doing on the video. And our auto, what do we call this? Our buffer. Our buffer of items is now set up and it's subnetwork. So this is the completed look. I've only have glass set up. I haven't set up anything else yet, but it's all there ready to go for when I get around to it. Everything we've been compressing, we now have a stockpile of one stack sitting in the chest. So, mission complete there. That's going to be really handy. It's going to stop any kind of slowness with the crafting as well. Okay, so where do I want this network to be set up for my furnaces? I think right here is fine. Right around here looks like a fine place. So what I'm going to want, I got 6 redstone furnaces. I think I could just place them... I'd want them outwards like this. If I place them one more apart, it might be a little bit better. So there's my redstone furnaces. They're going to connect up to an impulse duct. That will be the input. That will be the input of them. I'd also need a separate for the output. Yeah, I think I need one more line for the outputs. The outputs will go to a chest. Where would I want my front to be? I think the front would be okay here, so give me a cover. One cover there. Throw my chest on top of the cover. Perfect. So this should output all the items we get into the chest. Those will be the inputs, so let's set up our furnaces. Input from the back, output on the top. Input, output. Good. Good. Set up this side. Wait, I did that backwards. Oops. Oh, it's getting late. I'm getting tired. I think I messed this one up too. Output on top, input on back. Perfect. Okay, so that'll all open to this chest, and the input will go in through the back. That's what I want. And I want my interface to be placed here. Interface will be placed there. I'll face it towards the item duct, just so it knows where to go. I gotta go underground quickly. Set this guy to output. I'm not sure if it needs a servo, but we're gonna put one in anyways. Servo on low. That should be fine, like so. Good. So that should throw items into the pipe and find the closest furnace available. And that should pull it all to the chest, which will be a basic import, like so. And then this line we have to connect to our main system, which I'm going to be pulling those out, but I think this will be okay. I think that'll be okay, like that. Yeah, let's find out. Might have to tweak the position of the import, but I don't think I do. So let's go with glass for starters. Glass and some basic processors. I'm gonna eventually move all the recipes down there. I just want to test first and see if this will work. So let's have glass and basic processors. And let's get all the glass out of here. And actually request... I already have it on there. Let's request a stack of basic processors. One stack. And we'll get some gold, or more glass being produced. Let's see what happens. So far, nothing. Okay, it doesn't know what to do, so I think if I put another chest, I think this will do the trick. Let me pull that off and pull that off. Let me get that servo back as well. I think this will do the trick like so. If I put another chest here, I put the interface there. Put the interface there. I face it downwards into the chest. Will that work? Will it input into that chest and think it's a craft? I don't know. And then I put the import on that chest. That should go through there. Let's find out what happens now. Servo. Definitely needed. For a chest. Let's see what happens now. Let's cancel the import as well. I can't open that chest. Ignore contents of the inventory. Get me a stack of processors. It's crafting silicon, which should be a pulverizer. Is it going into our system is the question. So far, nothing of the sort is happening. It is crafting me dust, though, or silicon. Silicon is being made. I think it's all getting jammed in that interface. It doesn't know what to do. Bugger, I was really hoping. Let's figure this out. Oh, you know what? I'm an idiot. It's going into the it's going into the furnaces. You know what the problem is? Not our setup. Setup was fine. I might not even need this chest. Setup was absolutely fine. I'm kind of upset by how stupid I was there. Setup was fine. They just have no power. We could fix that. What would be a nice way to run a conduit to these? Underground. There we go. Setup is fine. Now it's doing its job. Yeah, that's nice. Let me see if I don't need this chest at all. Let's try and move this down one. Let's see if the interface will pull into the item duct automatically. I'm kind of curious about that. Whoops. Let me grab these out and see what happens. So maybe I do need that chest there, because it appears nothing is arriving through the interface into the item duct. So I think I do actually need that chest there to be the buffer, because it still has the crafting jobs. So it's definitely trying to make more, it's just not arriving. Okay. So the buffer chest is a requirement. Buffer chest, interface, and face you down. Now we're lighting up. Yep, now it's working. So buffer chest is an absolute requirement. We can throw these back in. And we can start pulling this into the network. Great. It's working perfectly. Alright, I think we got a really nice setup done now. We have all of our bars and everything we compress stored in a stockpile of a stack, and we have this entire row left for auto-crafting stuff in a stockpile, like glass. I'm probably going to do ME cables, silicon, I don't know, whatever I feel like having in a stockpile without having to wait for the crafting recipe every time, we have the available option there. I also got these pulverizers, so I'm going to do the same thing I did with the redstone furnaces, just so it's much faster auto-crafting, like much, much, much faster. I don't have two furnaces trying to handle all my jobs. I'm going to move all my recipes down here as well, and you better believe it, you could put another interface in the front, one on the side, one on this side, yeah. And we can even space it out more, add another chest with more interfaces. So you can honestly have as many furnaces attached to as many or as little auto-smelting jobs you want. So I'm going to grab all of these. And I'm probably going to steal that. We're going to add on one more interface here. There we go. Because I know this won't be enough. So we're going to store all that in that interface. Whoops, I exported. Uh-oh. What did I export? Rubber. Oh, now you're good. And we'll face you towards the chest. And we'll connect a lion. Like so. There we go. Now this is our two furnace auto crafter. Set up to six furnaces with one buffer chest. Should be perfectly fine with this little setup, and that should mean significantly accelerated crafting. Like I said, we're gonna do the same thing with the pulverizers. You can expand or do whatever you want with that setup. I'm pretty pleased with what we have right now. Pretty pleased. It's working great, and I think we'll see you all next time. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something about a subnetwork. Maybe we'll see you next time.